पुराने जमाने के
टीचिंग के तरीकों से
हमको क्यों पढ़ाते हैं,
इट्स सो बोरिंग।
अब वेदांत देगा प्रॉब्लम से छुटकारा।
हाय किड्स,
हेलो टीचर। आएगा तो मजा आएगा तो समझ आएगा।
बेस्ट टीचर्स पढ़ाए तो सिंपल लगे एवरीथिंग।
लीडर बोर्ड एंड क्विज़ेस से
अमेजिंग।
समझ आएगा तो मजा आएगा।
Vedantu, learn live online. To attend a free live class, download the app now.
Hello, future of India. I welcome you all in this beautiful session that we're going to do on tricks. I hope that your preparation for JEE 2020 is going great and you are all excited to kill this examination in January itself. We are doing all this so that we can support you at every level we can. So if you haven't liked, share and subscribe to the video yet, do it now, because if this video will reach to more people will be able to access the tricks that I'm giving in this session, right? So bahut hi mind boggling tricks hone wali hai, bilkul maza aane wala hai. Just stick with me for the entire session, you're gonna love for sure. So let's move in there. Before that, a quick announcement I want to make, ki micro courses are available. If you haven't learnt a particular chapter yet, you can do it on Vedantu, because Vedantu is giving you chapter wise courses as well. So koi bhi laddu topic abhi tak you haven't prepared, then do it now. This is the link, you can go to this link, and if you could use this code, you can avail a discount of 95%, right? So what is the code? ASMIC. Use this code to grab this discount. I'll be quickly moving into the session. Let's go into the question number 2. Right? Yes, here it goes. It is saying a complex number is called unimodular if its modulus ka value is equal to 1. Now, number 2, it is saying that this complex number is unimodular. What do I understand from this? I'm going to tell you this Fadu trick by which you can solve this question like in 5 seconds. Want to know? Let's go into that. So the question is saying mod of z1 minus 2z2 divided by 2 minus z1 z2 bar is equal to nothing but 1. What it is clearly mentioning in the question, that your z2 ka modulus should not be equal to 1. This is a problem asked in JEE Main 2015. Now see how smartly I will solve this. The question wants to know ki z1 kidhar lai karega. Z1 kidhar lai karega? This is the question's demand, right? Yes. Now, Z2 ka modulus 1 nahi ho sakta as per the question, right? But can I say ki this can take any modulus apart from 1? Z2 can have any modulus ka value apart from 1. So why not take Z2 as 0? Because if I take Z2 as 0, mod Z2 kitna ho jayega? 0, and that is fine by me. Because the only restriction given to me in the problem is this. So it satisfies the given constraint, right? So the moment I put Z2 as 0, what I'll be having from this problem is nothing but this. So what is this thing, mod Z1 equal to 2, which is what? Z1 lies where? Z1 lies on a circle which is having radius 2. So which one is my correct answer? The correct answer is B. Isn't it easy, interesting, guys? So if you are solving the questions like this, these tricks in the JEE examination, obviously you'll be having enough time to go for other questions, right? Ye competitive exam in which we need to save our time as well. So isn't this trick interesting? If you find this trick interesting, do like and write whatever you need in the comment section so that I can help you by that. I'll quickly move on to the next question so that we can do very interesting questions. Now, in the very same question, I want to give you one very important thing. Always remember this formula. Always remember this formula. Always remember this formula. That in complex number, this thing will be helping you a lot. In this question, as I can see, this thing modulus was given to me 1. So I can square both sides. The moment I can square both sides, I can write the left hand side by this property. This. And I can solve the question. This is the subjective method. I'll be attaching this in the PDF, so you can download it from the description as well. No need to worry, yaar beta, har cheez milegi. Telegram group join nahi kiya to abhi bhi kar lena Vedantu ka. Now coming through the third question, right? This is a JEE Main 2019 ka question, and from the topic mathematical reasoning. It is one of the very laddu topics that they're gonna ask questions on, right? Yes. So my agenda in this question is to tell you that these things are important, always do them, never ever leave them. So I'll give you one quick concept over here so that हम आगे बढ़ सकें. और ये ट्रिक, ये क्वेश्चन देने का मेरा एजेंडा ये है कि हमको पता लगे कि यार ये लड्डू टॉपिक है, इसको करके जाना है. ठीक है. यस. नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस थिंग, व्हेन एवर सच काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग इज गिवन टू अस, व्हेन एवर सच काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग इज गिवन टू अस दैट वन स्टेटमेंट इंप्लाइंग अनदर स्टेटमेंट, द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस इज negation of A union B, negation of the first statement, union the another statement. That's it. If you remember this formula, your question is halfway done. Let's see how. It is asking me what negation of this thing. So this is my first statement written over here. I have to take negation of this. So first statement ka negation le liya. Union second statement, that is Q. Now negation of negation, negation is same as complement, isn't it? Yes. So I can say कि कॉम्प्लीमेंट का कॉम्प्लीमेंट इन द सेट्स, व्हाट डज इट कम, इट कम्स द वेरी सेम सेट ओनली. सो आई कैन राइट दिस थिंग एज पी एंड हियर आई हैव गॉट दिस. नाउ इन सेट्स यू माइट हैव लर्नड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर्मूला, दैट इज डी मॉर्गन्स लॉ. व्हाट डज इट से, डी मॉर्गन लॉ इज अप्लाइड ऑन दीज टू फॉर्मूलाज. नाउ आई विल टेल यू वन वेरी ब्यूटिफुल ट्रिक टू रिमेंबर दिस. ओके. डी मॉर्गन is a England cricket team ka player, he is a very good player. So what he does, he changed the line length of the players by hitting them so hardly, right? Yes. So how we will remember these formulas are, first he compliments the bowler that you are good. Okay. So he gonna give compliment to A as well as compliment to B. Then what he'll do, he will change the line length of the bowler. That means if union is coming over here, what he'll do? He will change it into intersection. He will change the line length of the bowler, yaar. Yes. So as per the same logic, first give the compliment to both of them and then change the line length. So this will become the formula. Now let's see the very same thing over here. Negation means complement. This stands for union only, right? So this basically, this problem is asking me about this thing. So by this formula, first give the compliments to P, give the compliment to Q, and then change the line length. So can I write this thing also as negation of P intersection negation of Q? If this is there, then what is the right answer? A is the correct answer. Isn't it easy, guys? Yes. So remember this formula number one and then this formula. These are two very important formulas which are there in the mathematical reasoning. So my agenda was to make you guys aware of this. Ki bhaiya yahan se laddu problem aate hain, karna na bhule, janhit mein jari. Chalo, aage badhte hain. Question number four. This is a JEE 2018 ka question, mains ka, determinant ke upar. Bahut smartly hum isko solve karne wale hain. Let's see how. This question is asking that this determinant is equal to this expression. What is the value of A and B in this expression, right? So I can see that this is a kind of an equation, right? Determinant mein ek alag tarike ka equation hai, right hand side mein another equation is there. So if we take any specific values of X so that we form two equations in A and B, the moment we have two equations, we are done with our question. A और B की दो इक्वेशन आ जाएंगी, दो वेरिएबल, वी कैन सॉल्व इट. कैसे? लेट्स सी. इफ आई पुट x इक्वल टू जीरो बोथ द साइड्स ऑफ द इक्वेशन, व्हाट आई एम गोना गेट इज माइनस फोर जीरो 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 माइनस फोर जीरो एंड हियर जीरो जीरो माइनस फोर, राइट? यस. ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड व्हाट आई विल गेट, this expression will go to zero. That's why I am putting x equal to zero, so that this b doesn't come. When I put x equal to zero, b goes. Right. So what I'll be having on my right hand side is A into A square, that is A cube. Can you tell me the value of this determinant? It is nothing but minus 64. So what is the value of A I'm having? A ka value mera aa gaya yaar minus 4. The moment I have got the value of A, I can see into my options. So A should come as minus 4. That means A option mera answer nahi hai. So B, C, D mein lafda hai yaar. Because B ka value change ho raha hai, B option C option D mein. So let's find out the value of the constant B. Kaise kare? Once we have got the value of A, what we do? We put another value of X and our entire expression will come in terms of B only. And we can find out the value of B. So why not? Let's put X equal to 1 into the problem on both the sides. What will happen to this? Let's see. This will be minus 3. This will be 2, 2. This will be 2, minus 3. And this will be again 2, okay. This is 2, 2 and minus 3 is equal to, on the right hand side, I have already got the value of A as minus 4. So I can write it as minus 4 plus B times what I am getting? 1 minus minus 4 ka whole square. Right? Yes. I can put any other value of x also. That is fine by me. Instead of x equal to 0 and x equal to 1, if I put any value, my question will be done. No need to worry. Okay, yes. Can I solve this equation? I can find out the determinant very easily. Or meri b ki value aa jayegi yaar. So what is the answer coming? Write in the chat box. I'm waiting for your answers, guys. Kya aa rahi hai b ki value? B ki value kya aa rahi hai? Bachche bol rahe hain 5 aa rahi hai. Is it correct? So agar a minus 4 aa gaya aur b 5 aa gaya, to what is the right answer? Option D is the correct answer, yaar. We can solve it like this, hai na? Yes, quickly aage badhte hain next question ki taraf. This is a JEE 2019 ka problem. One of the very interesting problem. I'm gonna solve this question by a trick. Let's see what is the question saying us. Let O point is given to us and A is another point given to us. These are two fixed points. So P point ka locus I want to find out such that perimeter of the triangle is constant. Perimeter of the triangle means what, yaar? Let's see this. Perimeter of the triangle means sum of all the three sides is constant. So AO will be one side, OP will be another side, and AP will be another side. The side length ka sum is equal to 4 given to me in the problem. Okay. Can I find out the distance between O and A? Because these are two fixed points. So I know that distance between O and A by distance formula is nothing but 1. So the moment I put here 1, what do I get? I get OP plus AP equal to 3. Right? Yes. Now, in conic sections, you might have learnt this property that if you have two fixed points ko I am calling focus. Mujhe batana ki kya aane wala hai. Theek hai? Yes. If I want to find out locus of the moving point, such that the sum of the distances from the two fixed points, sum of the distances I am saying, that means what? S1P plus S2P. This is, if this is constant, what is the locus on which the P point moves? Isn't it an ellipse which comes? Isn't it an ellipse? Yes. So I can say that the locus of P will be an ellipse. If it is an ellipse, I can say that option A cannot be my answer because it is an equation of what? It is not an ellipse. Certainly, it is not an ellipse. Number two, it is not an ellipse. So, option A and option B cannot be my answer. Option C and option D will be, so out of these, my answer will be there. Now, if I want to solve it subjectively, what I can do, I can assume the point P as H, K. O is given to me, I can write down the distance of the OP. Similarly, A point is given to me, I have assumed the point as P as H, K, I can write down here, and what I'll get is nothing but the equation of the locus. But I'll tell you smarter way to solve this problem. Right, yes. Now, if the moment I see the two fixed points in this problem, what are they given to me? Number one is O, that is origin. And another one is A given to me, that is 0, 1. So it will be lying on the y-axis. The point A will be lying on the y-axis. Somewhere here, let's say A is there. So if my focus is lying on the y-axis, two fixed foci are lying on the y-axis, the ellipse should be forming such kind of a shape. That means it will be inflated more on the y-axis. That means what? In the equation of ellipse, B will be greater than A because it is a vertical ellipse that is forming. Number one. If these are the two foci of the ellipse given to me, can I find out the coordinates of the center of the ellipse? Yes, I can. What is the midpoint of this point? It's nothing but the center of the ellipse. So it is coming 0 over 1 by 2. So this is my center. Can I write down the equation of the ellipse like this if I know the centers? Here A square will come, here B square will come, and this is equal to 1. Now, what this property says that S1P plus S2P is constant and it is equal to what? It is equal to length of major axis. Length of major axis. Yes, major axis vertical ke case mein kya ho jayegi? 2b. That means I can say that this value is equal to this expression. So this 3 should be equal to what? It should be equal to twice of b or not length of the major axis. So my 3 is equal to 2b. So from here, can I get the value of b? My b is nothing but coming 3 by 2. The moment I put my b over here, what do I get? 3 by 2 ka square, right? Yes. If this is my equation of ellipse, can I observe that b has to be greater than a? So if I take the LCM, this 3 by 2 square will be multiplied with x, and this a square will be multiplied by y square if I expand this term. So coefficient kiska badaega? X square ka badaega ki y square ka badaega? Coefficient of x square will be bigger. So if I see option C and option D, in which option my coefficient of x square is greater? Kis option mein bada hai? C wale mein bada hai? That means my answer has to be C. So I'll revise it once again. The important properties: if two fixed points, whom I'm calling as what? Foci. And a moving point ka locus I want to find out, such that this distance plus this distance is equal to constant, then the locus will be a ellipse. Number one. Number two, this distance ka sum should be equal to length of major axis of the ellipse. Here in this case, it is a vertical ellipse. That's why it should be equal to 2b. So this was the length given to me in the problem. So this is equal to 2b. How, if these are my two foci, I can find out the center. I write the equation like this and I can respond with the correct answer. Hope you enjoyed this session and liked the tricks that I have shared you in this video. So don't forget to share among your friends, right? And don't forget to hit the like, share and subscribe button, because if you do that, I'll keep on working hard for all of you guys and I'll give you smarter tricks like this in a series, so that when you guys appear for your JEE exam, you have these kind of FADU methods in your mind, so that you can kill questions in that limited amount of time, right? I hope your preparation is doing good. Keep faith in us. Your faith means a lot to us. We will be trying to reach out with you with more tricks. And here comes our question number one. This is a problem asked in JEE Main 2014, right? This is a vector ka question which is dependent, which is on STP, right? Triple product, right? It's a very, very, very easy concept. If you haven't learnt yet, do it now. In this session, my agenda will be to solve the question with the tricks. If you don't know the concepts, then you can tell me in the comment section. I'll be happy to do quick revision videos for the topics also, right? But as of now, my agenda in this session is to solve this question, and that too in a smarter way by which we can get more marks in our exam. So let's move into the session, guys. This question, if I see, is dependent upon A vector, B vector and C vector, and it is asking me the value of this lambda. If I see the options over here, all the options are constant, right? Yes, that means if I take any A vector, any vector B and any vector C, I can solve this question very easily, right? So what I'll do in order to solve this question is, I'll assume A vector as I cap, B vector as J cap and C vector as K cap. The moment I do this, what will happen to the question? Let's see. My question will become I cross J, J cross K and K cross I, right? On the right hand side, it will become lambda times I cap, J cap and K cap. By this trick, I can solve my question in a few seconds. I'll tell you that as well. But first, this is another objective trick by which we should go, right? Yes. Now, if you guys know the trend that IJK follows while doing cross multiplication. If you don't know, then focus on the screen here. If I want to find out I cross J, what is the term that is going to come? It's going to give me K, K cap. If I want to find out J cross K, it is going to give me the next term, that is I cap. If I want to find out K cross I hope you know it is nothing but it will be coming J cap only, right? So what I'm saying is I cross J as per this rule is nothing but K cap. J cross K is nothing but I cap only. And this K cross I is nothing but J cap only, equal to lambda times I'll be having I cap, J cap and K cap ka square. If you know physically the significance of this thing, you can do this question orally and your question is done. The correct answer I want you guys to write in the comment section. Before that, I want to give you quick concept of the box product over here. If I'm having P vector, Q vector and R vector in a box, it is nothing but first vector dot product of the two vectors and that to cross product, right? So this is the meaning of the box PQR. If I apply this over here, I can write it as K cap dot I cross J. This is equal to lambda times I dot J cross K ka whole square. Now, I cross J is again K cap. So I can write K cap dot K cap equal to lambda times what is J cross K as per this rule? It is nothing but I cap. So I can write it as I cap ka whole square. Now, K dot K, it is 1. I dot I is nothing but 1. So 1 ka square will again become 1. So this is nothing but what is the value of lambda you are getting? 1. That is your correct answer D. Your correct answer is D. If you use this tricks, you can solve the question orally. So what I'm trying to say from here is, this question is dependent upon 3 vectors, A vector, B vector and C vector. Since this lambda is coming constant, so it will be satisfied for any values of A vector, B vector and C vector. That's why. Number 2. Now, the meaning of the physical significance of this thing is what? It is the volume of the parallelopiped which is having one vector as P vector, another vector as Q vector and another vector as R vector. So a parallelopiped will be formed. This is the volume of that. Now, if you look at this expression, one is K cap, one side is K cap, another side is I cap. So obviously it will be perpendicular and the third side is J cap. So all the three sides are perpendicular. That means in this case, parallelopipe will become what? It will become cube. Why I am calling cube, not cuboid? Because the angles are perpendicular, but the side lengths are all same. The magnitude of this side will be K cap ka magnitude 1. Is side ka bhi magnitude 1. And this side will also be having magnitude 1. So all the sides are having magnitude 1. So in that case, this parallelopiped, which is having all the sides perpendicular, will become nothing but cube. Or cube ka volume hota hai 1 if the side is 1. Right. So you can solve it by that logic also if you know the physical significance of this. If you don't know, no need to worry. This is the thing we can solve the question by. Right. I hope you enjoyed the trick. So don't forget to hit the like button if you enjoyed this trick. If you want to know more about Vedantu, what we are doing, you can download the app of Vedantu. A whole lot of things are already there. Right. Yes. And then this is one very important announcement I want to make. You guys might have heard that don't try this at home. We are professionals, that we are pro, right? Don't try this at home. But Vedantu has got you a Pro Lite subscription, which involves what? It involves all the micro like courses that are going on. It involves all the test series that we guys are doing, right? Yes. So you can manage your curriculum anywhere. You can manage your schedule, right? And you can learn with us. This is if you are a grade 11th link course you want, this is there. If you want a grade 12th link, this is the link. If you avail this code, if you use this code, you can have a discount of this much price, and instead of this big amount, you can get it at 11,249 only, right? So pro banne ka, pro subscriber banne ka, and that too, it is a limited period offer. So jitna jaldi karoge, it will be better for you. Every possible way I can. Milte hain next session mein. Bye bye.